Moon, hi Mad Max, hi Chiku. Can you guys hear me? Can you guys see me? Hey guys. Yeah, okay, great. I've been struggling to start my live stream. I don't know what's happening. Hey guys, I hope everyone is doing great today. How's your day going so far? How's everyone doing? How's everyone? Yeah, I hope you guys can hear me. Okay, so we are doing a poetry. Yeah, all fine. Why are you speaking on everyone? I'm joking. That's great. Okay, so we are doing like a little nice poem today called the Rugby League Game. Okay, hang on. I'm just typing it down for you guys. Okay. Hi, Messi Martha. Yes, can I see those high fives? Okay, hang on. Let me type this down for you guys. Okay, there it is. Okay, so that is our poem for today. Does anyone know what rugby is? Or do you guys have rugby in your country? Anyone that knows what rugby is? Yes, it's a sport. So do you guys play rugby in your country? Is there rugby in your country? And tell me what... Oops, my phone keeps falling. Okay, so do you guys like rugby? Is it in your country? Do you know anyone who plays rugby? Any famous players? What do you know about rugby? Hang on. I can't even hear my own music is still playing. I'm sorry about that, guys. Okay, so Messi Martha said rugby is a sport. Yes, that is correct. That is 1000% correct. So what else do you guys know about rugby? So we are doing a poem about the rugby league game. This is one of the poems I did in high school, and I really liked it. At first it was kind of like, okay. But now, as I grow older, I start to understand the meaning of poetry, the words behind them. So I decided, let me just share this poem with all of you guys. So Messi Martha said, rugby is a sport. So what else do you guys know about it? If you don't know anything about it, just say, I don't know anything. If you do, just tell me what you know about rugby. I'm trying to get my phone. Hi, Prismac. Is that how I say your name? I'm so sorry if I keep botching your names, guys. Okay. So, yeah, no one is saying anything, but that's okay. So let me show you guys what rugby is. I know some Polish word is hard to say. Oh, you Polish. Hi, Danny. Okay. So this is rugby. For those of you guys that don't know, I'm just going to turn my laptop so you guys can see. Oh, my camera and not my laptop. Okay. So this is the game of rugby. Okay. It's quite rough. Okay. As you can see, there's tackles. It's just a rough game. Okay, a really, really rough game of rugby. That is awesome. Nice meeting. I don't think I've ever met anyone from Poland before on this app. Nice to meet you. Okay, so this is rugby. So Messi Martha said it is quite similar to football, but the ball is oval or stretched round in shape. Here the ball could be taken in hands to put goals. Yes, so that is accurate. That is 1000% correct. So this is a game of rugby, and actually South Africa won the Rugby World Cup, the recent Rugby World Cup. When was it? 2019, before the pandemic. So South Africa are like the, for now, it is the number one rugby team or country in the world. Okay, so that's just a little bit about rugby. I remember in school, rugby is a very, it's very, very popular in schools. A lot of kids love rugby. It's very, it's just very popular. But I would think it is more popular than soccer. Soccer is literally number one in South Africa. And then I would say rugby is number two. Hi, Leo. Okay. So it is kind of like American football, but it is played with your hands, right? Yeah, your hands. So it is quite different from American football because with rugby, you don't wear a lot of protection. I know with American football, you have to wear like a helmet and all of that. With rugby, no. There's no such thing. You just wear your shorts and your t-shirt and that's it. If you get tackled, it's a very dangerous sport, honestly. Do you see? These rugby players do not have any sort of protection anyway. Do you guys see that? So if you get tackled, if you get thrown on the ground, it can get really hectic really fast. Really? Let's take a look. Let's see what YouTube has for us so you guys can understand the concept behind it. And then we're just going to get into it with the poem. If you guys would like to hop on, that would be great. Okay, so request for a hop on. Make sure you guys are subscribed so we can do this poem together. Okay, so yeah. So let's see what YouTube has for us. Okay. So I'm looking for a nice little short. Okay, so let's just watch this for now so you guys can understand rugby, for those that don't know rugby. Okay. Okay. Who else hates YouTube ads?
Suggestions are provided.
YouTube has a lot of ads. Okay, there you go.
The Queensland v New South Wales rivalry has been burning for 140 years now, and this matchup is the perfect way for us to get the 2021 Harvey Norman Super Rugby AU season started. Oh. Sliding it wide to Greasy on the angle. There goes Maddox. Pops beautifully. Maddox for Gordon.
Okay, do you see all the tackling?
Inside the first three.
What a
start.
Yes. So do you see that?
Jack Gordon.
Do you see how anyone can just be tackled at any time? It's very dangerous. It's very, very dangerous. Do you see they don't have any protection gear with them? Anyone can just throw you anywhere on that field. Okay. Do you guys see the ball is... Okay, hang on. Yeah, it is very brutal. Okay, so that's rugby. I hope you guys can just see the brutality, okay? So they throw the ball backwards. So they stand in a line, but the ball has to be thrown backwards while they run forward, okay? So don't get confused. Does that make sense, okay? So the team... is on the other side. The other team is on this side, okay? So they have to meet in the middle of the field, and somehow they have to pass each other so they can score a point, okay? So while they are running forward, the ball can only go backwards, okay? So you throw the ball backwards to your teammate while they run forward. So that's just how they get the ball to move forward and score a point. You get tackled. It's very strong. They don't win. That's rugby. That's the rugby game. So we are going to do a little poem. This time it is not a South African poem. It is a poem From someone who was born in England. England is also very, very popular when it comes to rugby. Yes, it's like reverse momentum. So you guys are moving forward, but you can only throw the ball backwards, okay, until you guys get to your poles and score like a point or something like that, okay? So this poem is by Falcorna Kirk Up. Okay, so we will read the poem first, and then we're going to explain the context and everything behind this poem, and then we're going to read it again, this time with the meanings of the words and everything, so you guys can understand, okay? I played rugby at school. That is great. And how was it? Did you enjoy it? Yeah, that's really awesome. In Poland, we haven't way to play rugby. So you guys don't play rugby in Poland? I don't know. I would have thought Poland has rugby. I don't know why. Poland just looks like a country that could have rugby. A little school team. Oh, that is awesome. That is great. And have you ever had any serious injuries while playing rugby? I know it's a lot different in high school, but still, it's still rough. And high school boys can be very, very rough. I wanted to play Quidditch for sure. What is Quidditch? Quidditch, like that? What's that? I've never heard of that. Okay, so we gotta get started. No, not professional. Yeah, I'm saying, have you ever gotten any injuries while playing in high school? Because you played in high school, right? When you were 17 years old. Okay, so let's get started. Okay, soccer is more popular in Poland, like rugby. Yeah, same with us. I would say rugby and soccer are like the same amount of popularity. Okay, so this is the rugby league game. So that's the name of the poem by James. Oh, I mispronounced his name. Okay, so it's James Kirk Up, okay? So this is the poem. I'm going to read the poem, and then we will read the background story and the content and the structure. If you guys have seen my first poetry videos, then you know what I'm talking about. Okay, hold on. Okay. So, make a search and let us know why about Quidditch. Okay, at the end of this lesson, I will look into it. In your leisure time, it's a game played in Hogwarts from Harry Potter. Oh, oh, so it's like a Harry Potter thing. Okay, I got it now. Okay, so, okay, it makes sense because I was about to say, okay, what is that? Because I did sports management and I've never heard of that, so I was a bit confused. But now it makes sense that it's a Harry Potter game. Okay. So, this is the rugby league game. Remember, if you guys want to hop on, you're more than welcome to request, or you can subscribe or hop on, okay? So, let's get started. So, it starts with, sport is absurd and sad. Those grown men just look in those dreary long blue shorts. Those ringed stockings. Edwardian, balding pates and huge fat knees that ought to be heroes. Grappling, hooking, gallantly tackling. Is all this courage really necessary? Taking their good, clean fun, so solemnly they run each other down with earnest keenness for the honor of virility, the cap, the countryside. Okay? Like great boys roll each other in the mud on public Saturdays. groping their blind way back to noble youth away from the bank. The wife, the pram, the spin dryer, back to the Spartan freedom of the field. Back to the days when boys were men, still hopeful and untamed. That was then, a gay and golden age ago. Now in vain, domesticated, men try to be boys again. Okay? So that's our poem. We all gonna go back to it. Yes, okay. So let's just read everything about the author and the content of the poem, the intentions and the structure. Okay, so this author was born in England on the 23rd of April, 1980. Hi, Jama, how are you? Okay, so in the little town of South Shields. So James Falconer, so yes, I did say his middle name instead of the first. Okay, so that was my bad. It's okay. Kirkup was a translator and a prolific writer, not only of poetry, but of more than 30 books, travel books, and obituaries, as well as numerous plays. Okay, so he was a controversial figure who was known for his quick wits, okay? So Kirkup left England in 1956 and worked in Europe, the Americas, and the Far East, lecturing and writing before finally settling in Japan, where he lived for 30 years. He has won numerous prestigious awards for his work and was still writing at the age of 90. Kirkup died in Andorra on the 10th of May, 2009, aged 91, okay? So he was very into writing. Even at the age of 90, he was still writing. So that's one dedicated poet, okay? So someone who writes poetry is called a poet, okay? Like that. So that's someone who writes poetry. So that's just a little background about the author. Born in England, and he had a lot of books and won a lot of awards. So let's take a look at the content of the poem. Let's see if you guys will be able to see. No. Okay. That's okay. I will enlarge it. Okay, so content. In this poem, Kirkup describes a game of rugby league, okay? So the game is being played by a team of overweight, probably middle-aged men. Do you guys know what age is middle age? When someone is like, you are a middle-aged man. Okay? So well past their prime. So their prime is like your beautiful golden years, probably your like 20s, 30s. Yeah, so that could be your middle age. I would say 40, 50-ish. Those are considered middle-aged people. 30 is still a bit young. I don't think anyone is old at the age of 30. Okay, so your prime is probably your 20s and your 30s, okay? So this Kirkup talks about men playing rugby, and he describes them as being overweight. We will see why he does that. Okay, overweight, middle-aged, past their prime. Okay, so they are no longer young. They are in the middle ages. Okay, so they use the game to try to recapture their youth. Okay, so he says these men are trying so hard to be young again. That's why they play this game. To escape the humdrum routine of work and their marriages and lives that have become boring, okay? So at around that age, you probably get bored and you just want to do something new, something exciting. So he describes these men as men that are bored of work and their marriages and their usual lives, and they just don't want to age. Okay, So in the midst of the game, the men feel as if they are boys again and return to a golden age. So he says these men wish that they were young again. That's why they still play this game of rugby. And as we read the poem again, you guys will see and understand the context. Let me try and open this blind again because... Okay. Oh, all right. I don't like this window because everyone that walks past just looks at me. And this is my room. Do you guys see it? So everyone just walks... See? Everyone just walks past, and whenever they just stop there, just look at me. So that's why I just close the window sometimes. But anyway, that's not the point. Hi, Abdu. How are you? Don't laugh, boy. They literally just stare like, okay, move. And I'm not rude, so I won't tell them to just like move. Like, what are you staring at? I'm just going to leave them or just close my blinds. Okay. No, if they wanted to say hello, then they just say hello. Don't just stare like a weird, creepy person. Okay, so let's read the poet's intentions. Okay, so Kirkup's poem satirizes. Okay, so it's a satire. So the men who tried to regain their lost youth. Okay. And who make themselves ridiculous in its pursuit. Okay? So he describes this man as being silly and ridiculous. You know, just accept your little small age and your old age and just live with it, you know. So he makes fun of these men. So it's a satire. No, I'm not Somalian. Okay, so the poem also makes fun of the importance of... fun of the importance that many men place on sports, okay? So the central theme of the poem is the futile pursuit of the lost golden age of youth, okay? So these men are really trying their best to be young again, and this poem, this poet is making fun of them because... you should just accept it when you grow. You know, people are bound to grow old, and that's just it. I didn't get you well. What are you talking about exactly? What are you talking about? Where did you not get me? Yeah. You all want to look younger. Yes,